In this video, we will look at how you can use a tool called PlayPosit to make edits to existing YouTube videos. It's very common for online teachers and teachers using a blended learning format to want to share YouTube videos with their students. But what if those videos have irrelevant content at the end, or in the middle, or at the beginning of the video? Or what if those videos have inaccurate information somewhere in the video, but the majority of the video is fine? Those imperfections can make the video less effective for your students. But by using PlayPosit, we can edit out those mistakes or irrelevant items and make the video as effective as possible for students. Let's now look at how PlayPosit can help us do this. Let's say I'm a math teacher and I would like to provide an educational YouTube video to help my students learn a good method for reducing fractions. And after doing some searches on YouTube, I find this particular video. However, as you can see, toward the end of this video, it has a series of requests for the viewer. It wants them to subscribe, join a mailing list, all of these things. It might be better for my students to not have to see those things. And also, I would love to give my students some guidance throughout this video to help make sure that they're understanding it correctly and to help them not get confused. I could use a useful tool called PlayPosit to do those things. There is a paid version of PlayPosit, but I'm going to log in to a completely free version of PlayPosit that you can also sign up for here on the sign up button. But I'm just going to sign in using my existing Google account, and it takes me into my PlayPosit homepage. Here I can create what they call a new bulb. And think of a bulb as just being an educational experience built around a video. So I'll click Add New Bulb, and it takes me to a screen where it teaches me a little bit more about PlayPosit, but I'll just click Enter the Designer. And now PlayPosit gives me 3 steps that I'll need to take in order to customize this video and add my own content to that video, edit it, and provide it for my students. Here in step 1, I need to provide PlayPosit with a video source. I could click My Videos and choose a video that I've used in the past, or I could record a video of myself speaking. I could import a video from YouTube, or upload a video that's on my computer that I've created. There's also an option just to put in a URL. In this case, that might be the easiest way for me to bring in this YouTube video. So here in YouTube, I'm gonna click once on the URL for the video. Just by clicking on it, it highlighted the entire web address. And now I'll copy it using Control C if I'm on a Windows computer, or Command C if I'm on a Mac. And then jumping back to PlayPosit, I can just click in this form and paste in the URL. PlayPosit is now analyzing the video and embedding it into PlayPosit. Also here in step 1, it is possible to change the video thumbnail if you would like. You can change the title of the video if you want, but in my case, I want to leave those the way they are. Next, I can either click Customize to move on to the captions, or I can just click up here on Captions to move to that step. And here, if I want to add closed captions to this video, I could drag a caption file here into this area to upload it. In my case though, I'll just click Customize to move on to step 3. Here in step 3, I can preview the video and decide if I want to trim out the end or maybe the beginning of the video. I can use this playhead to preview different parts of the video. So I'm going to go toward the end of the video right here. Test it out.
All right, so that's it for that.
So that's where I want to trim the end of the video. To do that, I simply click here on this red pin and drag it to approximately the right place. If I want to, I can also trim the beginning of the video. If I'm happy with that, I can click Done. Okay, now that I've done those 3 steps, if I want to, I could make some advanced adjustments to the video. For example, I could add a second video segment to my PlayPosit activity, or bulb. By clicking here, I could go back to those original 3 steps, choose another source, and basically combine or mash up these 2 videos together. In this case, I don't need to do that. So I will move on to interactions. This is another advanced edit that I can make to the video. PlayPosit gives me a number of templates that I can choose from. If I want to add a discussion, I can just click apply. And as you can see, doing so would add a discussion forum on the sidebar for the entire video so that people watching the video can discuss and make comments. I could add a pre or post assessment template to have a quiz at the beginning and a quiz at the end. There's also summative assessments, formative assessments in the form of checking for understanding, and a variety of others. For now though, I just want to close the template gallery to get back to this page. Here, I can add specific interactions that don't come in the form of a template. So I can just click here on Add an Interaction, and it gives me a number of exciting options of things that I can add to this video to make it even more educational and useful for my students. For example, I would like to start with a free response activity. So I just click Free Response, and the question or writing prompt is, tell me how comfortable you are right now with reducing fractions. Notice that there are some options for formatting my text. I could even record my voice prompting the students instead of typing, and there are some other advanced options here. But I'll just click Done, and because the playhead was at the beginning of the video, notice that this interaction will take place at the very beginning. Let's say partway through the video, maybe I want to do a formative assessment to see how well the students are understanding. Again, I can come down here and click Add an Interaction. This time it will happen at this point of the video, at 38 seconds. I could add a word bank here for the students to choose from. I could do a check for understanding, a multiple choice question, and that's what I'll do. So I just clicked to select multiple choice. Here's the question or prompt. Underneath the question, I can type some answers. I can add additional answers if I would like. And I select the one that is the correct answer. There are some other advanced options here where I can give the students feedback if they pick this particular answer. But for now, I'll just click Done. And now I have a second interaction in my video. Each time I add an interaction, it's added to the timeline here in the form of a dot. There are several other interactions that you can add, including embedding items from the web. For now, I'll cancel out and move on to the Review tab. Here in the Review tab, I have some playback options that are important to look through and some privacy options. When I'm done, I can click Save and Exit, and my PlayPosit is created. At this point, I can go over and click on these three dots to assign this PlayPosit activity to my students who are signed into PlayPosit. But if you don't want your students to have to sign into PlayPosit, you can click here to simply share your PlayPosit activity with your students. There are some advanced settings as well, including an embed code. So turning on embed code, I'm going to copy that code and I'll go into my Canvas course. Let's say I'm teaching this math course through Canvas, and I'm tempted to paste in the code here, but it won't work unless I first click HTML editor. Now I can click and paste in the embed code, click save, and the YouTube video that I just edited in PlayPosit is now embedded into my course on a particular page, and my students will be able to click begin. Before the video starts, my prompt comes up, and they have to click and type in their response about their comfort level with reducing fractions. They click submit and continue.
What's up, fourth grade?
And the video begins.
Welcome back to Mashup Math. This is going to be a very short lesson where we get to apply our problems.
The students can close this panel to be able to watch the video better.
Test questions, and it is aligned with the Common Core learning standards, and we get to take a visual approach to solving it. Let's go ahead and check it out.
This button closes the panel at the left, and they can resume the video.
Fourth graders out there, thank you for joining me on this short problem where we are going to get some more experience with visualizing fractions and thinking about them in different ways.
When they get to my next interaction, in this case a quiz, it pops open and they can put in their answer, click submit, it's marked correct, and then they can resume watching the video. When you get to the end of the video, look what happens, it cuts out the end of the video because I trimmed out the end of the video. PlayPosit has many other excellent features, but I've shown you all the basics and a few advanced features to get you started using PlayPosit to edit and customize YouTube videos for your students.